will be a series of classes and short segments of 10 minutes, approximately 10 minutes, that we will be discussing the 13 principles of faith, the Yud Gimel Ikrim, which are the essentials, the fundamentals of Emuna and Bitachon, of faith, belief, and trust in Hashem, in God, which are not only essential and critical to Jewish philosophy, faith, and belief, but also, as we will learn, part of, or a critical part of, the essence of the Jewish person, the essence of the Jewish man. So we're going to start with the actual term Emuna, and for those of you who are not privileged with the opportunity to be here to see me live and are watching from the video, I'm sorry to tell you, but the camera's not working very well today. I have a lot more hair. Usually there's something wrong with the focus. I have the same issue with my mirrors at home, and we're working on it. But we're going to discuss the topic of Emuna. Emuna is a word that is very often used in Judaism, but we are going to try to define, also to describe, but to define the word Emuna. What does the word Emuna mean? So many of you will say that it means belief, it means faith, it means trust. I'm sure, I don't know if a real woman named Brenda, you know, Lesserberg exists, but I'm sure if she did, she would say as follows. Rabbi, I understand Emuna, which is a women's league that was founded in 1935, which was a critical part of the World Zionist Organization, specifically for women, and that's what Emuna is in my world. And I would say, of course, thank you, Brenda. Yes, I was referring to the concept of Emuna. Well, Rabbi, our concept, our mission statement is that we want to forward and we want to better the world and bring everybody closer to it. Yes, yes, Brenda, thank you, thank you. That is definitely one of the translations of Emuna. We're going to focus slightly on a different translation of Emuna. So as we said before, the simple, the most commonly used term to translate the word Emuna is faith or belief. But I'd like to share with you the words of the Ramban. The Ramban, one of the early Rishonim, who was one of the great Talmudic philosophers and sages of the generations, has a fascinating thought that really penetrates the Jewish heart, and it really depicts exactly what Emuna is. And he says as follows. The Torah tells us that Moshe Rabbeinu, Moses, ordered his servant or his prime disciple, Yehoshua, to battle the nation of Amalek. And Moshe Rabbeinu went to the top of a mountain with his brother Aaron and with his nephew Hur. And they went to the top of the mountain, and Moshe Rabbeinu raised his hands high in the air. And as long as his hands were outstretched, then the Jewish nation was victorious in their battle. But the second that he let his hands go down, then the Amalek nation would overcome and be victorious over the Jewish people. So obviously, Moshe Rabbeinu wanted to keep his hands outstretched. But they were kfeidim, the Torah tells us. They were heavy. They were hard to keep out. Try it yourself. Try to keep out your hands like this. I don't know how the Statue of Liberty does it. She's been doing it for years like this. I don't know. I hope she uses deodorant also. But how does a person keep it stretched out for so long? So his brother and his nephew, Aaron and Hur, they assisted him to keep his hands in that formation by putting a rock for him to sit on, and they both, each one, held out one hand. And the Pasuk tells us, the Torah says, Bayihi Yadav Emuna. His hands were Emuna. His hands were faith. His hands were belief. His hands were trust. What does it mean, his hands were Emuna? Says the Ramban, a very powerful insight. The Ramban says that the translation of the word emunah is not have faith. It's to be faithful. When Moshe Rabbeinu's hands were emunah, when the pasuk, the verse says, "Vayehi yadav emunah," it doesn't mean that his hands had faith. It means his hands were faithful to what he wanted them to do. He wanted them to stay out. He wanted them to be outstretched. And though it was difficult, they stayed that way. So they were faithful to what he wanted them to accomplish. So the Ramban says that technically the translation of the word emunah would not be faith, but faithful. The difference between faith and faithful is not just the F-U-L-L spelling at the end of the word. There's a much more powerful difference between faith and faithfulness. Faith does not necessarily require testing. Emunah, belief, trust, does not necessarily require going through difficulties or standing up to something or being challenged. Faithful requires going through a challenge and remaining faithful. The blessing, the bracha that we give to a chatan and kala, to a chasen and kala, to a bride and groom when they get married is that they should build a bayis ne'eman. Literally, it would sound like it means a house, bayis ne'eman, of belief or faith. And although there's truth to that, but it's also a house of faithfulness. You should both be faithful to each other and to what you want, to what you believe in. Faithfulness is not just a abstract concept, a belief, or a system of intellectual clarity. Faithfulness is to stand with what you believe in, stand strong up to other challenges, and be faithful to what you believe in. There's an old Yiddish story. A man wants to find the proper shidduch, the proper husband for his daughter. So a young man asks or offers his hand in marriage, and the girl and the boy meet, and the father of the girl, the possible bride, says he'd like to meet the chassan first. He'd like to meet the young man, see what he's all about. So he says to the young man, he says, "So what are you going to do, as far as parnasa? What are you going to do as far as making a living?" And the man says, the young man says, I have faith in God. So he says, "Well, what are you going to do if things get hard and, you have to pay tuition and you have to pay, for a house and rent and more? What are you going to do?" He's like, I have faith in God. And he says, "Well, what are you going to do, down the line? You're going to have children and you're going to have to marry them off. And how are you going to, put food on the table?" He says, I have faith in God. So the father-in-law says, okay. He goes back to his daughter. He says, "He's a very fine young man, but he thinks I'm God because I'm going to provide. He thinks I'm going to be the one to pay for everything." Faith sometimes appears as if it's a concept like that. Like, yeah, I have faith in God. It's in the back, on the back burner. Like, oh, everything will work out. What the Ramban is telling us is that faith is not enough. It's not some abstract concept. It's to be faithful, to stand strong with what we believe in. When we're going to have to deal with challenges or difficulties, don't whimper, don't dry away, melt away. No, we stand up to or against what we're facing because we are faithful to Hashem. The more the challenge, the more we can prove our faithfulness. To paraphrase John F. Kennedy, ask not what God can do for you, but what you can do for God. Don't just have faith and say, "Yes, God will help. Yes, God is all merciful. Yes, God will take care of me." That's not enough. Faithfulness is, what can I do to prove my faith to God? How can I stand up to the challenges against me, stand strong in what I believe, and no matter what happens, no matter what I'm tested with, no matter what I go through, I will be faithful to my own faith. That is the end of our first segment of Emunah.